Have you been enjoying it so far?
It's been incredible. I turned up this morning and literally there was a queue going around the entire place about four times. It's overwhelming how big this con has got, and I'm over the moon to be a part of it.
Excited to see the con grow, but of course, I mean, some of the shows you've been involved with themselves have an amazing following, none more so probably than Torchwood. Why do you think, I mean, how can you explain the extraordinary success of that series?
We've just been saying, actually, been signing here today and all these photos of all the different characters I've played, but with Torchwood, I think we've been off air about 3 years now, and it's still alive. It's unbelievable. And if we thought for 1 second in that read-through on the first day that this was going to be this huge global beast phenomenon, I don't know how we would have reacted. We had no idea this was going to happen. It's just a big, bold, sexy, fun show, and people really took it to their hearts, and we appreciate it more than anything.
Of course, fans have their favourite characters and their favourite episodes. For you personally, are there any of both that you're particularly fond of or particularly proud of, I guess, when it comes to episodes?
My favourite episode of all time is Countryside, because I'm a huge horror fan, and anything with blood and guts and cannibals I like, in a strange kind of way. I just thought it was nice to get out of the hub, and we really enjoyed that. And we all kind of, we got to go away for a couple of days together, all of us. And yes, you know, John Barrowman had a few beers, and it was good fun. But that, I loved that episode. But I'm out of the entire season, I think Children of Earth for me was a big turning point for the series. And we finally found out who and what we wanted to be.
Your character is one that fans absolutely adore. I mean, what do you think it was about Gwen that people latched onto so much? I mean, within the pantheon of female sci-fi characters, she's a firm favourite for many fans.
Oh, that's nice to hear. Thank you very much. I think it's because she's not all teeth and bat. You know, she's somebody you know, and she's somebody who struggles every day with work life and family life. And whether you're a superhero or whether you're saving the world, you've got a full-time job and a family, it's very difficult, and people see that. When they see that on television, you can identify with it. That, and she works with the most beautiful men in television, which is incredibly envious of most, you know. But she's a modern woman. She's a modern mum. She's a warrior. She stands up for what she believes in, and she does not give up. And she's feminine, but she's not like silly feminine. She's a strong, iconic woman.
Couldn't have said it better. Now, of course, I mean, a lot of the shows you're involved with have a strong sci-fi fantasy element. What do you think fans get from that genre that they perhaps don't from other forms of drama?
Well, they get what I miss. I mean, when I'm not doing sci-fi, I miss it so much. I miss the magic. I miss coming on set every day and going, what's this monster look like? What does this alien look like? What planet are we on today? What, you know, it's endless, and it's escapism, and it's fun. And what I love about sci-fi is that we're all big kids, and that genre allows us to be any age we want to be, because we can escape to it. And I love that about sci-fi. There's no restrictions or limits. You can just be and love whatever you want.
Love talking to you. We have to let you go to a photo shoot, but my very final question, there's been a lot of talk lately about will there or won't there be more Torchwood. What's the best you can tell us at the moment? What's the position, and would you like to do more?
That's it. I wish I could, you know, I hope it goes again. There's a huge want for it to go again. What I can say is that when they call, John and I will be there.